Howdy, slowpokes. Welcome back to Animal Crossing New Leaf. As you can see, I've been doing a few QR codes here. I've got a couple there. This one's pretty cool. It's a Kappa's hat. There we go. Anyways, I'm going to switch back to my normal clothes instead of my sheriff's outfit. Maybe if I get a cowboy hat, I'll use that again. But anyways, today, I've got a few letters I got to get rid of first. Let's get rid of... Yeah, I'll mess with this. I don't need this from Gulliver. And I don't need any letter from Brofino. We can just toss out. Okay. So today, you might have noticed yesterday, I forgot to start another public works project. So today I'm going to get on that. But I think it's actually a good coincidence because I saw Red yesterday. And here's a letter from him.
Dear cousin... No.
What was his voice? I can't remember.
Dear Cousin Adam, Old Red wants to thank you for coming by Red's gallery and purchasing a very fine motherly statue. This delivery completes your purchase. All sales final.
So yeah, I actually got a real one now that I know how to identify which is, you know, real and which is fake. Oh yeah, Cranston came by. Hi, Adam. Thanks for having me over the other day. Made me decide to clean up my house too. And look what I found behind my candy wrapper volcano. What? Here, you earned it, gratefully. Cranston. Let's see what... Cranston actually came over and he left on his own accord. I didn't have to kick him out. So that was cool. He found a daffodil. Thank you, sir. And we got the motherly statue. I'll throw the motherly statue down real quick, maybe, so you guys can see it. It's the Romulus and Remus one, like the one where they're nursing on the wolf. I know the localizers were talking about how they had to make the decision not to censor any of the art. And, you know, there's some pretty hardcore teat suckling going on here, but... It's art, and it's old-timey, so. And then we got this daffodil. Let's check that out. It's a daffodil. Okay, I'm not sure if that is a an actual, you know, one that that sits in one of the feng shui colors or whatever, but. So anyways, the first thing I want to do is head over to the museum, and I've got some perfect pears over here, I just noticed. I'll get those later. My perfect pear tree grew. But we're going to head over to the museum past all the butts, take a right at the butts, and we'll be there. And there I'm going to donate that piece of art, and I think that will be the last... I don't have any art pieces yet, so once I do that, hopefully that will trigger something. And okay, so Nooks is being upgraded, I forgot about that. But I think we have a new shop. Oh, no, it's taking another day. Man, there's so much construction going on. So hopefully tomorrow we'll get two new, you know, a new shop and an upgraded shop. But let's go donate this, and I think this is enough to unlock an extra special public works project. So let's talk to Blathers here. My Kappa hat is so weird. Hey, how's it going, buddy? I'm going to make a donation. It's the first time I've done this on camera in a while. I usually go on my own here just to throw stuff in. There you are, my good feathered friend. It's a leaf.
Ooh, unless I'm mistaken, there's a motherly statue. Indeed, what joy it is. Oh, well, we shall take very good care of this. Yeah, my word.
All right. Thank you very much. Is he going to mention that... Oh, nope. I thought he would mention that I've got a piece of art in every area now. So I kind of want to actually go through real quick before we do too much. I'm gonna head over and just... We're going to browse some of these things. Because, look, I've been... Oh, Tangy's even here. Aw, this little dinosaur's really cute. Let's see what she's up to.
Gah, oh, it's just you. I thought you were a fossil for a second, Adam. What's up?
What's the latest?
If I were a fossil here, would I get tired of everyone always staring at me?
But I just want to see how my collection is going along pretty decently, swimmingly, if you will. But I've been collecting a lot of fossils, a lot of bugs, a lot of fish, and I haven't actually been in here in a long time. So yeah, see, we got a lot of stuff going on in here. I just thought I'd take a look. This mammoth is complete. Sweet. And then let's see what the mammoth says about the mammoth.
Mammoth. The mammoth was a giant woolly elephant-like animal equipped with long, deadly tusks. Aside from protection, the tusks were also likely used to clear paths through the snow. One theory states that mammoths became extinct at the end of the last ice age due to lack of food.
That's unfortunate. Alright, we're gonna head back out here. I might check out the bug area and the fish area, but I don't want to spend too much time here because we got some stuff to do. We got public works projects. Ooh, that one's almost done. That one is done. Is this the thing from Jurassic Park 3? The Spinosaurus, yeah, it's the one that fought the T-Rex in that movie, and I'm not sure if they actually could take it. I remember not that long ago, I wanted to, like, look at a that fight scene, because I hadn't seen Jurassic Park 3 since it came out. So I looked on there, and like all of the YouTube comments were just a lot of, you know, dinosaur nerds debating back and forth, like whether the T-Rex would win, whether the Spinosaurus would win. It was like going back and forth. It'd be like, this is so unrealistic. The T-Rex would destroy the Spinosaurus. Like, it was just hilarious to read all those comments and interesting, like, because the movie obviously portrayed it that the Spinosaurus was a lot stronger, but I don't really know for sure. Wait, oh, the hermit crab counts as a bug. I didn't know that. I thought it would be a sea life thing. I never really thought of them as bugs, but I guess they are, because in Pokemon, the hermit crab is a bug type. Not that Pokemon is a good, you know, a good science reference.
Oh, Aram, how's it?
I forgot her voice.
How's it going? It's so crazy around here. Lop off.
That's not her voice. I can't remember her voice. I'm having a really hard time remembering all this stuff.
What's up?
There we go. That's a lot closer.
I'm the kind of girl who notices the details. I can even tell the difference between a beetle and a cockroach.
As you can see, she has a new catchphrase, lump off. I gave her that so that she would she'd be a little bit more like Lumpy Space Princess. Whoa! Sorry, little guy. What are you? Hopping around. Didn't mean to almost step on him. Let's go check out. Yeah, this museum is really filling up quickly. But I've already spent a lot of time here. I should probably head out. Oh, there's my bird wing. Lots of stuff everywhere. There's a beetle. I wonder if the mosquito can bite me, and I can't, like, retaliate against it, because it's in the museum now. It's a work of art. But anyways, what was I going to say? Oh, the Spinosaurus thing, like, I know that Jurassic Park doesn't really get a lot of dinosaur facts right, so I wouldn't be surprised if, like, the Spinosaurus couldn't actually defeat the T-Rex, but if you know, if you're a dinosaur dork, let me know. There's nothing wrong with that. I love dinosaurs. I was really into dinosaurs as a kid, I think from seeing Jurassic Park. But if you know more about the Spinosaurus, let me know, because I am interested whether... I don't know if anyone can really say. I get you can, like, compare the stats, but who knows whether one could beat the other, because we have never actually seen them in real life. Like, there's so much stuff about dinosaurs that we thought we knew, and then it changed over time, and, like, we think they have feathers and stuff now, and we used to think they were more lizard-like. Like, yeah, okay. Anyways, ooh, this looks kind of nice. It's a green zap suit. Let's try that on, because it does a little sound anyways. Rain or rain. I don't really need it, though. There's so many zap suit colors. Let's check out over here. There's some camo pants. Nah, I'm not too interested. I'm going to talk to her, even though I don't need... Oh, Adam, welcome. Oh, so now it's at the point where I don't know if she's gonna really say much. Oh, if you're looking for some clothes shopping, let me know. Yeah, she's probably not going to say all that much to me because I unlocked the QR thing and I've done my duty and she's opened up. So let's check out the accessory side. Oh, there's one of those crazy crowns that are super expensive. I have nowhere near enough to buy that. Daniel really wants this little crown. Someday I'll get it for her. And there's a watermelon hat. Watermelon hat. It's a pretty good choice. Let's try it on. If you want to dress up as a watermelon, I highly recommend it. Let's try it on. It's very similar to my Kappa hat. I'm not gonna do that though. Alright, yeah. Nothing really that amazing here. I'm gonna step out. Let's head back to town, and I'm gonna go see if the public works project that I want to start has been unlocked, or if I have to wait another day or something to do it. I keep forgetting, I want to try to catch one of those birds in my bug net. I don't think it'll let me, but because it lets me, like, use my net in town, I think it's, like, possible. Maybe that's an Easter egg. Anything on the message board? Yep, something new. Let's see. Today's Graham's birthday! Oh, crap. I forgot. Tomorrow is the summer solstice, longest day of the year in Gooseton. Careful not to stay up too late just because you can. Alright. So I forgot it's Gramps' birthday. I gotta send him something. How about a daffodil? I might actually send him the daffodil. Because I don't really want it that much. And maybe he'll appreciate it. Let's head over here. I also want to see if anyone's moved into the campsite. But I'll go mess with that later. I'm gonna head into Town Hall. Mira's creeping behind the Gooseton Goose flag. And let's see if the public works project that I want to start has opened up. Ooh, she looks awfully cheery today. I'm gonna pop in my chair here. The dream thing is, like, super expensive that she talked about last episode, so I'm not sure about trying to do that, but that would be a really good way for me to visit you guys' town to, like, you know, let's start a new project. Alright, let's see what we can do. Dream Suite. Yeah, that's the new one. Who knows what it'll look like, but it costs about $250,000. Anything else here? Whoa! A chair sculpture? That looks like a boot to me. What? That's really expensive, too, even though it's kind of cool. Do not enter. Face cutout. Fire hydrant. I might do something cheap, since the thing that I want to do isn't unlocked yet. Water well. Yellow bench. Suspension bridge. How about... What's the cheapest one on here? Probably the yellow bench, right? Yeah. None of these little ones are that cheap. Let's try a yellow bench. Let's do it. That way I can get that done, and I could probably pay it off today and get it done for tomorrow. Let's go find a place to build. I need to make a trip to the island, because I am about 200k in debt to Tom Nook for my last house upgrade. Where would be a good spot for a yellow bench? Somewhere by the water would be really nice, I think. So you can sit and look at the river flow by. How about right here, where I'm talking to you? Yes, Mayor. Is this about where you'd like to do? What do you think? I want to see what it looks like. Move the plants. I hope it doesn't destroy these trees too much. I'll look around a little bit more. Having it right on the cliff might be kind of cool, too. What do you guys think? I ask that, but by the time you leave your feedback, I've probably already decided where I'm going to put it. But I think... Oh! It rained yesterday! I forgot! A mini clankoid! So there's going to be gyroids everywhere. Sweet. Maybe I'll put the bench near the campsite. Because they're kind of... They go hand in hand a little bit. Man, hope this is another one. Nope, it's a fossil. Still pretty good. But yeah. There's not really a bad thing to dig up. I'm kind of sick of getting pitfalls at this point because I have like a whole thing full of them, but you know, what are you gonna do? Camp Gooseton's camping site. I wish someone would come and camp there. How about right on the, I don't know. I wish I could turn it this way and have it at the cliff's edge like that, but I don't think I can. I could put it like right here, maybe. Come a little closer. Come here, baby. How about right here? Let's see what it looks like. I'll have that way it's out of the way because it's not really all that important, but I want to make sure. That's pretty good. That looks good to me. I hope I don't have any important plants right there, but either way, they're gone. All right. I don't want it anywhere major because I'm going to probably put some more important stuff in spots later. All right. I think I'm just going to pay it off right now. Hey, Lloyd. How's it going? 30k in your pocket, buddy. Let's build this bench. Do it. Even one bell for the price of a cup of coffee. Here you are, buddy. Alright. Bam. 30,000. The project's complete. It was as easy as that. We didn't even have to set up the... I could have just given it to him. I don't know. Alright. So, that's mostly it for today, I think so. I'm still waiting. There's another project I really want to do that I think will be unlocked now that I've donated a piece of every piece of the museum thing, you know. So yeah, this tree's still growing. Nobody special around here. I'm going to go down to the beach just to see if maybe Gulliver's there or something special's going on. And then we'll end it out for today. Oh, you know the one thing? I'm expecting something... There we go. I knew that rock was weird. I'm expecting something to happen at retail, and I want to make sure that I record if, you know, I'll be recording anyways, but I want to make sure that, you know, I am there to see it. So let's, I'm just going to run along the beach real quick. Yeah, I don't see anything. I'll come back later. Maybe Gulliver will be back in town, because I already saw Red for the second time, so I'm, like, expecting Gulliver's the next guy to pop up. But, we're going to head over to retail, and then if nobody's in there or nothing's going on special, you probably know what I'm talking about. But if nothing's different, then I'll end it out. But if something's different, we got something to do in here. What's our special item for today? Snail. I haven't seen a snail. I think when it's like raining, they pop up on flowers or something. I don't know. Let's see. Yes, I knew it. Oh, you kid, are you? Oh, they're flirting. Oh, Adam, welcome to the shop.
Hey, I haven't seen you around here before. Are you bothering my wife?
Oh, Cyrus, don't be so silly. This is our new mayor, Adam.
You've been here in town quite a while now, but my Psy guy's always sleeping since he's so tired. I guess you two haven't had a chance to properly meet yet.
Whoa, you're serious? I'm shocked I haven't met him till today. Sorry
to get all in your face like that. It's just how my poppy raised me. You ever dealt with an alpaca poppy?
Well, don't!
I'm Reese. Partner's Cyrus. I like messing with old furniture, refurbishing it to turn it into something new and interesting. My Psy guy is the very best when it comes to refurbishing. He can change the paint, redo the upholstery. If Cyrus gets his hands on it, any piece of furniture can become wonderful in the blink of an eye. Ain't that the truth? If you got any furniture you're sick of, why not bring it here before you toss it? Turn it into something so great that it'll be like it's reborn anew. But I better not catch you making Google eyes in my way, for I'll make you see things in 4D. Look at my butt.
All right, let's go talk to him real quick. This minimalist table that I put for sale is probably something I could have sold. What is this? A hipster chair? A sloppy chair. Man, I'll take it to add it to my catalog, and then I'm going to sell it again. That's what I've been doing with some of this stuff. So Cyrus is over here. Let's talk to him. I don't think I have anything he can do.
Yo, Adam, what can I do for you, Squirt?
Got a project for you. Oh, a project, you see. I'll be the judge of that. Let me see if you got anything that stands out to me. Oh, you've got something good. Can I take a closer look? What is that?
My sloppy chair.
What is he going to do with it?
So he brought me a sloppy chair. Cool. The scarf, I say we customize that.
Do it for 40 bells.
Nah, that's alright. I'm gonna mess around with putting this on sale. I'm gonna get my bed, and maybe I'll put a custom pattern on that. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. It's good to meet you finally, Cyrus. I'm gonna sit here where you were sleeping and do that for you. I'll see you next time, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed this, and see you tomorrow for more Animal Crossing.
Hey, Cyrus, how's it going? Let's do some customizing here. I've got a project for you.
Oh, a project, you say? I'll be the judge of that.
Let me see if you got anything that stands out to me.
Oh, you got something good. Can I take a closer look? Let's do my green bed. Let's see how this brought me a big green bed. Okay, the frame can definitely be customized, the bedding as well. Set you back 216 bells, though. Still interested?
Yep, let's do it.
Great. First off, let's plan a bit. And that means deciding what to do with the frame. What do you suggest? My recommendation? Let me think. Now that you mention it, you got some ore on you, yeah? If I use said ore, I could make something that really stands out. How about it? Let's try making an emerald one, I guess.
Oh, good, great, wonderful. Well, show me the ore you want to use.
This one here. Just got this emerald ore today. Right, I'll then so I'll give the frame the old emerald treatment. Okay, got that. It's simple. Benny is next. What do you feel like? How about a custom design? All right. I'm going to put the Gooseton flag on my bed. I think that'll look nice. All right,
Squirt. You all right with me going ahead with the project?
Yes, please. I wish I could see it before he was done. All right, let's do it. Here's the emerald. Here's the leaf. Get going, buddy. All right, leave the rest to me. Take about 30 minutes or so, so go kill some time and come back. Oh, so you know, if you ever write the custom design, the design on the item will change too. Sure to remember that for later on if you futz with your designs. Oh, okay, so he's going to work on that. All right.
I simply adore the flower you gave me the other day, Elvis.
What a relief. I'm not so good when it comes to picking things out like that. I thought I had a nice sweet scent, like a rainbow sherbet. So anyway, I'm glad you like it.
Well, of course I did. It was such a pretty color, but it seems like I saw a flower like that somewhere.
You did. I picked it right out of your least favorite person's front yard.
No, you didn't. You took it from someone else's yard without asking their permission? You know, that makes your flower much more special, so thanks for the thoughtful gift.
What a bee.